What is the best protein patty supplement for honeybees? Last week, we started our conversation about a recent scientific publication where Dr. Vincent Ricigliano from the USDA Bee Research Lab in Baton Rouge and Randy Oliver from scientificbeekeeping.com compared different commercially available honeybee diets in the market. In the video number one, we could see that two brands containing natural pollen stand out, building strong colonies at the end of the trial: Global Patties and Homebrew, a homemade recipe from a beekeeper. Also, the study showed that healthy bee patties were the worst, not only delivering the weakest colony at the end of the study, but also the only brand that the bees rejected and threw it away from the colony. No surprises here. But what many people at home were surprised about was the performance of Ultra Bee, the leading protein patties in the market right now. How can the leading brand perform so well in one day and so bad on another? This research was partially funded by Project Apis M. More about them at the end of this video. To be honest, I'm not surprised at all. And at the same time, I don't think Ultra Bee is a bad product. As I mentioned in this channel many times before, honeybee research is a complicated field because we cannot control most of the variables when performing our experiments. When we look at all honeybee trials on nutrition ever published, it is clear that we don't have all pieces of this puzzle. Emily Noordyke, working on her master thesis in Dr. Jamie Ellis' laboratory, published a great review on this topic. After reviewing all published studies on bee nutrition, she concludes, "The collective literature suggests mixed results. This is due to a few primary reasons. 1. There is a multitude of diets to test. 2. The diets can have different formulations which change frequently. 3. There is a great variability in the environments in which tests are conducted. 4. Results from laboratory studies do not necessarily reflect what would occur in the field. And 5. Many of the diet studies are missing key design elements." The two main components of Randy's studies, in my view, are the number 2 and 3 from this list. The diet can change frequently and the environment can bring surprises. To discuss all the details of the trial, I invite Randy Oliver for a live stream, and all of you at home are invited to follow it live. Randy has published in his website another trial comparing protein patties before, with results very different from this new study. Let's compare Randy's previous trial against this new one in collaboration with the USDA. On the old trial, from August to November, all groups started with 5 frames of bees, and 3 of them showed some growth while other groups went down, with Ultra Bee being the champion at the time, winning even against natural pollen. In the new trial, from August to November, all started with 8 frames of bees and all of them lose colony strength, some of them drastically. Interestingly, in the old trial, all experimental groups bounced back in February, growing substantially, reaching colony sizes bigger than the beginning of the trial. However, in the new study, only a couple of groups grow back in February, and only Homebrew surpasses the original colony sizes from the beginning of the experiment. The first conclusion is that in the new study, the bees did not grow as they would normally grow. Why? Did the bees consume the patties? Apparently yes, the data showed that. This means that the bees were well fed and we need to look in another direction to try to explain what's going on here. Why didn't the well-fed bees grow as in previous studies? Something must have happened in the bee yard to all colonies, independent of the diet. Randy describes no queenless colonies were found. Perhaps some another queen issue? Perhaps the biggest lesson here is about the importance of honeybee research. Discoveries about honeybee nutrition can fundamentally change the industry. However, it is very hard, as you can see here, with all these variables that we cannot control. And also, it's very expensive. That's why supporting Project Apis M is vital. Project Apis M's mission is to fund research and efforts to improve honeybee health. Project Apis M is behind many important projects about honeybee health that I covered in this channel in the past. For example, Dr. Kara Wagner worked on varroa mites, Project Apis M. Dr. Ramsey's work on varroa feeding on fat bodies, Project Apis M. My own work on viruses in the past, Project Apis M. I want to take the opportunity here to thank Project Apis M for the work they do and invite everyone at home to visit projectapism.org and consider a donation. Thank you. Next week, I will continue to cover Randy Oliver's study, looking at what the researchers found when they look at the amino acid content in each diet. Good stuff coming up.
If you like this video, please consider subscribing to the channel and also supporting us on Patreon. I also want to invite you to watch this next video right here. Thanks for watching InsideTheHive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week.